May 1st is commemorated as International Workers' Day, also known as Labor Day in some places. It's a public holiday in many states in India. But why do we celebrate it? 1st May was chosen to be International Workers' Day in order to commemorate the Haymarket affair in Chicago. The police was trying to disperse a public assembly during a general strike for 8-hour workday when an unidentified person threw a bomb at the police. The police responded by firing at the workers, killing 4 demonstrators. It is seen as the victory of labor union movements, which demanded and advocated for 8 hours of work, 8 hours of recreation, and 8 hours of rest. May 1st is also a very important date when 2 announcements were aired about 2 of the most dreaded men in history.
This is London calling. Here is a news flash. The German radio has just announced that Hitler is dead.
The United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda, and a terrorist who's responsible for the murder of thousands.
Even though bin Laden was actually killed on May 2nd, the announcement came on May 1st in US due to its time difference with Pakistan. It's not good to celebrate death, but the world indeed breathed a sigh of relief after these announcements. The German Minister of Propaganda, Joseph Goebbels, committed suicide on May 1st, 1945 after Hitler's death. Well, talking about announcements, May 1st is also the date when the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, better known as North Korea, was established, with Kim Il-sung as leader in 1948. Hence began the reign of cult personalities who created stories about double rainbows and changed weather according to their moods.
I don't know about all that, but this one is the one that I heard. I heard he doesn't pee or poo.
He works it so hard, he burns the energy from inside.
You're telling me my man doesn't have to take a poo? Does he have a butthole?
He does not have a butthole. He has no need for one.
The leader of Cuba, Fidel Castro, chose May 1st in 1961 to proclaim Cuba as a socialist nation and abolished elections in the country. Back in India in 1960, on May 1st, we got 2 new states, Maharashtra and Gujarat. Due to a series of protests, the Bombay Reorganization Act was passed by the Indian Parliament to divide the multilingual state of Bombay into Gujarat and Maharashtra, with Ahmedabad and Bombay serving as their respective capitals. May 1st is also the date when we armed ourselves against one of the deadliest diseases in the world, polio. It was on this day in 1955 that the polio vaccine developed by Jonas Salk was made available to the public. Salk campaigned for mandatory vaccination. For him, public health was a moral commitment. When asked who owned the patent for the polio vaccine, he replied,
"Well, the people, I would say, there is no patent. Could you patent the sun?"
Another major feat of human triumph against odds happened on May 1st when Japan's Naomi Yumura, traveling by dog sled, became the first person to reach the North Pole alone. By the way, did Spielberg's Bridge of Spies enthrall you? Well, it was on May 1st that Francis Gary Powers in a Lockheed U-2 spy plane was shot down, an event that triggered a major diplomatic crisis during the Cold War that ultimately ended with the exchange of Soviet intelligence officer Rudolf Abel at the Glinicke Bridge that linked West Berlin with Potsdam. It was this bridge that became famous during the Cold War as the Bridge of Spies. Well, that was a brief history of May 1st. We will be back tomorrow with a new episode. If you like the show, please like, share and subscribe. Do leave your suggestions in the comment box. And if you're born today, a very happy birthday to you. For after all, you share your birthday with a very beautiful and talented Anushka Sharma.